SugarCRM and Salesforce are two powerhouses in the tech field, and combined they have helped over 150,000 customers with their CRM, customer relationship management, needs. So it's safe to say that they're both well-liked, but how do you pick between them? In this video, we'll help you narrow it down. But before that, click the link in the top right corner of the screen or in the description to check out Technology Advice's recent list, the best CRM software to find the best solution for your business. We've helped over 2 million people find the right software for their needs. And with that squared away, let's start digging in. We've done vids covering both Salesforce and SugarCRM individually, so we'll focus on specifics starting with lead management. SugarCRM lets users visualize leads by status and uses Sugar Predict AI to identify potential customers. It's also fairly simple to convert successful leads into contacts. However, the maturity and sophistication of Salesforce's lead management functionality is second to none. Salesforce lets users assign the right sales reps to converted leads and grants access to web-to-lead record generation, duplicate lead blocking, and market campaign management. So for lead management, we've got to give it to Salesforce. Now on to contacts management. While SugarCRM treats contacts management as a sort of database of demographic and account details for each customer, Salesforce takes that base functionality and extends it. Salesforce's collaboration features allow various team members across an organization to share insights, internal account discussions, and relevant documents for every contact. Salesforce also uses social content feeds to get an understanding of what your contacts are saying about your products or services, allowing for proactive customer service. That said, BI is only as good as the info gathered, so there will be a lot of time invested to enter and track data, which might be too much for smaller companies. For contact management, we're giving it to Salesforce as well. Next, and we know this one is a big one, pricing. Salesforce has a lower per user per month cost for its most basic plan, which can be pretty appealing for smaller companies. It also has no minimum on this plan while currently. SugarCRM has a 3-user minimum. That said, while Salesforce starts lower, you decide you want some of the features that are in the higher tier plans, the price leap is pretty significant. And for our next comparison, we'll tell you all about it in our next video. But if you're an eager beaver and want to learn more about other CRM options, you should visit our website, where you can see our list of the top CRM options available today. You can click on the link in the top right corner of your screen to access that. If you like the video, then like it and subscribe so you can stay up to date with all of our videos. Remember, your success is our mission, and we're here to make sure you win. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.